One of the major functions of RBI is to formulate the monetary policy. So what is this monetary policy? What are its major objectives? What are the two major types of monetary policy? This is going to be the topic of our discussion today. So talking about monetary policy, it's actually the macroeconomic policy that controls the supply of money in the economy. So how much money supply will be there? How much will be the availability of the credit? What will be the interest rates charged? All that is determined or is based on the monetary policy. So talking about the three key objectives of this policy, money is needed for all the activities. We need money if we want to finance our education. We want to buy a new house, we need money. We want to start our own business, we need some funding. We already have some business, we are employing numerous people, we are generating employment. So to pay for their salaries, to pay them the bonuses, we need money. So money is needed for all these kinds of things. So all the economic activities require money, and those economic activities basically bring in the economic growth. So one of the major objectives of monetary policy is to promote the economic growth. By supplying the credit, by supplying the money in the economy, it makes the funding available for all these growth related activities. Second major objective of monetary policy is to make sure that the inflation remains within the target levels. If a lot of money is circulated in the economy, everyone has a lot of money, money is available in abundance. So obviously the demand of different goods will rise because people have the money to buy those things, and then we'll see inflation, the rising prices of all the goods and services. So we need to make sure that only such supply of money is available which prevents the inflation from happening beyond the tolerable levels. So that is how the RBI tries to maintain the balance between how much should be the supply of money. Okay, how much to supply, how much not to supply. The third major objective of monetary policy is to ensure the stability of the monetary system and the financial system at large. Now, talking about the two major types of monetary policies, we can have expansionary monetary policy or a contractionary monetary policy. As the name suggests, expansionary means to expand the supply of money, to increase the supply of money in the economy. And contractionary means to contract, to reduce the supply of money in the economy. Now, there might be different situations when the RBI would like to increase or contract the supply of money in the economy. Before coming up to those situations, let's first talk about how RBI can increase or decrease the supply of money in the economy. It can be done using different monetary policy tools. We'll be discussing those tools later on in some or the other session. To mention some, we have the reserve requirements, we have the repo rates, reverse repo rates, we have the buying and selling of the government securities by RBI. So through all these instruments, RBI tries and controls the supply of money in the economy. For example, we go to a bank and deposit say rupees 100 with the bank. Now banks will use that money to further lend the loans. But as per the reserve requirements, banks cannot use this entire 100 rupees, this entire amount which we are giving in the form of deposits to lend the loans. It needs to keep certain amount in the form of reserves so that the bank does not suffer from any liquidity issue. Okay, if many people like us go and withdraw their money, bank has cash available to pay us. So this reserve requirement, if is increased by the RBI, then there will be less money available with the banks to lend. Suppose out of rupees 100, 10 rupee was the reserve requirement. So bank had 90 rupees to lend. If RBI increases this reserve requirement, it makes it 20. So now banks will have just 80 rupees to lend. So that has reduced the supply of money in the economy. That extra 10 rupees would have been utilized in some other business, in some other economic activity, and would have promoted the economic growth. So by increasing the reserve requirements, RBI can basically restrict the supply of money in the economy. Similarly, it can increase the rates at which it lends to the banks. Banks can further increase or decrease the rates at which they will lend us. So monetary policy has to be framed keeping in mind both the objectives of economic growth and controlling the inflation within the tolerable limits. So now let's talk about when a bank will prefer an expansionary policy or a contractionary policy. Think of a situation like COVID where people are suffering, where the businesses are suffering, they are not having funding available. What RBI did? It relaxed the policy. It increased the supply of money in the economy. It reduced different rates. It basically tried and inject more liquidity in the economy. So that is an expansionary policy, which means that during a slowdown, recessionary, some distressed kind of a situation, RBI is willing to follow expansionary policy and increase the supply of money. Talking about the contractionary policy, it's usually followed in cases where there is high inflation. So if the prices are rising, there is a need to control the supply of money in the economy. If people will have more money, they will demand more, the prices will continue to rise because supply is not there. So in such cases of high inflation, contractionary policy would be useful. So this was all which I wanted to discuss about the monetary policy. Thank you.